a quotation lead. So we have to be sure when we borrow quotations, when news stories, when they begin quotations, they have to be sure to put quotations around the quotation mark, and they have to give credit to the person who said it. It is, we know, even in writing articles, we have to acknowledge the source from whom we borrowed those words or the statements. So we have to acknowledge the source. Of course, the quotation must be directly related to the topic. That is very important. It must be related to the topic. And a good source of any book, that is enough for us to provide quotations. And here I have an example. Please listen to the example for this quotation lead. Example, President John F. Kennedy once said. So this is, a quotation. President John F. Kennedy once said. And this is a quote. Ask not what your country can do for you, and ask what you can do for your country. Quote. Ask not what your country can do for you, and ask what you can do for your country. Unquote. So I think today's Americans have forgotten, this is actually a news story, forgotten Kennedy's message. So we expect our country to take care of us, but we are not taking care of our country. So this is the highlight. Is the reporter, he wanted to share, or he wanted to refer to the statement made long back by President John F. Kennedy, and he starts with a quotation thinking that that might attract the readers. So that must be the quotations that you include in news stories must be relevant or must be related to the news story. That is important. And next is question lead. So question lead opens actually with an interesting question that relates to the main idea. For example, have you ever wondered how you would survive if you found yourself alone in the wilderness? So this is a question. How would you defend yourself against predators? How would you eat? Where would you find water? So these are the questions. So full questions. Might be a paragraph or even two. Many questions. This is question lead. Next is announcement lead. This open with an announcement about what is to come. However, the reporters, they should not insult the reader by saying something like, I'm going to tell you about. So the reader should be able to figure out what you are writing about. If not, there is something wrong with what you have written. So it is not with the reader. So the reader should be able to figure out what the reporter is trying to say. Otherwise, there is some problem in the writing. That is announcement lead. And next is opinion lead. So this type of lead, usually, it will open your opinion means the reporter's, writer's opinion. So it should open with the reporter's opinion about the topic. So listen carefully, here is the reporter's. It must open with the reporter's opinion about the topic. So this is similar to actually a bold and challenging statement. Because the reporter is expressing, he is given freedom there in that particular page to express his opinion. So this is similar to bold and challenging statement, but yet the reporter knows that reader know what is your opinion right away. So, when you state your opinion in the beginning of the news story, clearly the readers can understand what is your opinion. You can even use words like in my opinion. So we use such phrases even in our writing. So according to my opinion. So in my opinion, when you use this word opinion in your writing, definitely it clearly differentiates from other stories, other type of stories. So readers can easily understand that it is reporter's opinion. So in my opinion, the driving age should be lowered to 14. So this is only my opinion, not the government's ruling governments or the opposition government's opinion. It is my personal opinion. The driving age should be lowered to 14. So this is how you have to express or state your opinion when you write news stories. So next is